All right, before you get set up, you're going to want a tool to take off the case. Usually it's held together with screws. You're going to want electrical contact cleaner or deoxidizer. This one isn't a deoxidizer, so I hope this will work. This one says it's for automotive use only. It actually says don't use on home electronic equipment, but I'm going to anyway. The reason it says that is some of them will actually melt the plastic on the circuit board. So just be mindful of that, and that's why I got some paper towel here. All right, so I went ahead and already gotten the screws out. Let's see inside. Normally the problem is in this potentiometer, so volume control, also known as a pot. Fresh pots! There might be some dust or kind of grime buildup.
And I've seen posts online, people using WD-40. Don't do it, it leaves behind a film, so dust and stuff will get stuck to it and you'll have the same problem. They do have a specialty electronic spray, so use that and not the regular stuff.
And we'll also take a look too at spraying some in the balance and the tone control. It might have to do with that. Also on this switch here. So I went ahead and already detached this. So if you have something like this with these clips, it's basically just like conversation on a first date. You don't want to force anything because the plastic is old. You just kind of work that in. I'm gonna stick the tube in here. I can't fit the paper towel under it, so hopefully there won't be any runoff and it won't ruin everything. Just right from there. I'll just kind of work it back and forth. That's actually feeling even better.
Some other causes of crackling speakers can be a bad ground, a bad solder, or cold solder. So check your connections as well. You might have to dive a little deeper into it, but try this at first because it's super easy and quick and it might just work for you. Thank you for watching.